Hey guys, this is Cray Cray here. I'm going to do my first ever video on nail polish. So what you'll need is black bands and the color of your nail polish choice. So first, you are going to make sure your loom is pointing with the arrows up. And you're going to make sure that the middle row is lower than the sides. Now you make sure that all your rolls are secure. Now, you are going to do doubles the whole time. So take double black bands and put them from the middle and up and do this 3 to 4 more times. I'm going to do 3. So 1, 2, 3. Now you're going to get doubles of your color and go from the middle and to the right and from the middle to the left. Now just keep in mind that the whole time you're going to be using double bands. Now again, go from the middle up. Now your loom should look like this. And now you're going to do each row 3 more times. 1, 2, 3. Now you're going to do your last row 3 more times. 1, 2, and 3. Now your loom should look something like this. And now you're going to take 2 bands like always and go from the middle to the right, but make sure you're going down, and from the middle to the left, again going down. So now your loom should look like this, and you're going to place a cap band on this peg. If you'd like, you can turn it around. Now you're going to twist it 3 to 4 times. So 1, 2, 3. I did it 3 times. And now if you have not done so already, turn your loom around to where it looks like this. Now you might start seeing how it might look like a nail polish. So now you're going to place arrows going downward. Or triangles, whatever you'd like to call them. So you're going to place one right above this arrow. And then once you have done that, place it one above. And do not do it right here, because that is already joining together. Now we are going to start the looming process. You need to go into the cap band. And if you'd like, turn your loom. But go into the cap band and grab these 2 bands. Make sure you only grab those 2. And make sure they're the right 2. Now, while you're taking them out, pull a little bit to where this folds like that. Now place it on the right peg. Now do the same with the left peg. And if you like, you can stick your hook in and push this back with your finger onto your hook. However you would like to do it, as long as it gets loomed correctly. Now you're going to go in and go to the center. Now I like to hold my bands down while I do this. If you grab an extra band, it's okay. Just place it back where it's supposed to go. Like that. If you still need another band, just try and find it. Sorry about this. I'll just place it over. Now, your loom should look like this. And you are now going to loom it normally up until these three pegs. Now, when you get to the triangle or arrow, you have to make sure you go inside those also. Like I said, only go up to here. Now your loom should look like this. And now, the reason you stopped there is because you now need to go in to grab the two. And then instead of looming it forward like this, you're going to loom it into the center peg. Make sure you do it on the right side first. Then after you've done the right side, do the left side. Now just loom the black normally. Sorry, this part can get a little tricky because you have a lot of bands loomed onto this one peg. Once you've got that, I would suggest pulling it to where this gets pushed into a triangular shape. Now, at the end, we are going to tie a slip knot. If you do not know how to tie a slip knot, I will show you how. You go inside the black bands from the tunnel out, and you're going to grab one black band and put it onto your hook. Then you have to take it out carefully without grabbing any other bands and place it back. Now you are going to take, the band should be placed like a V. You're going to take the one furthest away from the point of the hook, and you're just going to take it off of the hook. So it should be lying like this, and you're going to pull the one that's still on your hook nice and tight. Now you are ready to start taking this off of your loom. It doesn't matter what pattern you take it off in, as long as it gets taken off slowly and carefully. I like doing it side by side. However you like to do it is fine. And if you would like to do it with your hook, that's okay too. Now, your nail polish should look like this. Now, I hope you enjoy your beautiful nail polish and paint your nails. And thanks for watching. This is Cray Cray telling you to stay Cray Cray.